It emitted a high-pitched shriek that inflicted intense pain in the eyes and ears of everyone in a 10-meter radius. Ear-like growths immediately began growing on those within 5 meters of it, covering their bodies in less than 20 seconds. Hello everybody, I'm The Rubber. Today, we bring you an SCP Foundation Keter Class Object SCP-1048. SCP-1048, also known as Builder Bear, is a small teddy bear, approximately 33 centimeters in height. Through testing, composition of the 1048 revealed no unusual qualities that make it discernible from a non-sapient teddy bear. 1048 is capable of moving on its own accord and can communicate through a small range of gestures. 1048 regularly shows affection to individuals in ways found endearing by most people. Affection is usually given in the form of a hug to the lower leg, but 1048 has also been observed dancing, jumping in place, and in 2 separate events, it has even drawn childlike pictures for janitorial staff. All Foundation personnel that have interacted with the 1048 have responded positively to its affection, even D-class with normally sociopathic tendencies. Attempts at direct communication with SCP-1048 have not been considered successful. Though it is capable of simple gestures to indicate a yes or no answer, it will often not react to lines of questioning concerning its nature or where it originated from. It is not known if this is because 1048 simply does not know the answers or because it does not want to answer. Though capable of drawing pictures, it has not used its art as a form of communication beyond showing affection, even when encouraged to do so. The more anomalous behavior of SCP-1048 was not observed until approximately 7 months after it was originally secured. It is hypothesized that 1048 is able to construct crude replicas of itself using various materials, by a process that is yet to be observed directly by Foundation staff. Dr. Carver has suggested that 1048 uses its endearing qualities to lull those around it into a false sense of security, allowing it to collect materials to produce these creations. Currently, there are 3 known creations of 1048, designated SCP-1048-A to SCP-1048-C. The nature of these creations has been in stark contrast to 1048's general behavior, as all have exhibited extreme violence towards humans. SCP-1048-A was first discovered wandering Site-24, accompanied by SCP-1048. It resembles a teddy bear, similar in size and shape to 1048, but is made entirely out of human ears. Witnesses interviewed reported that it appeared 1048 was giving a tour of Site-24 to 1048-A. Dr. Carver was called to the scene, along with a security team. The security team arrived first and attempted to contain 1048-A. 1048-A emitted a high-pitched shriek that inflicted intense pain in the eyes and ears of everyone in a 10-meter radius. Ear-like growths immediately began growing of those within 5 meters of it, covering their bodies in less than 20 seconds. Every person afflicted with this symptom died within 3 minutes, resulting in the death of the entire security team. Autopsies revealed the cause of death to be asphyxiation, caused by an abundance of the ear-like growths manifesting in the mouths and trachea of all victims. 1048 and 1048-A fled the scene before Dr. Carver arrived, and have not been contained since the incident, though sightings of both have been reported on multiple occasions. Shortly after this incident occurred, a researcher was discovered missing an ear. According to him, it was removed through unknown means while he was sleeping. No other victims of ear removal were found, so it is unclear if SCP-1048 obtained more ears from another source or if it is capable of duplicating objects or materials. SCP-1048-B was discovered by several Foundation staff members in the cafeteria of Site-24. Its appearance was nearly identical to 1048, but it moved in an irregular, jerky manner as if something is moving inside of it. 1048-B made no attempt to interact initially, until a burst in its seams revealed what appeared to be the hand and arm of a human infant poking out and grasping at the air. At the sight of this, a female researcher screamed, and 1048-B reacted by emitting a high-pitched cry similar to that of a human infant. It then attempted to forcibly enter the uterus of the screaming researcher, causing massive internal damage. In the ensuing chaos, a security team was forced to contain and incinerate both the researcher and 1048B. Approximately 3 hours after this incident, a Foundation's doctor was found unconscious and bleeding in her office. An abortion had been performed on her while she was sleeping, and the 8-month-old fetus was never found. It is hypothesized that 1048 used the doctor's unborn child to create 1048B. Information regarding the possible origin of 1048B is not to be leaked to the survivors currently undergoing therapy for the incident with 1048B, as Dr. Carver believes it would be extremely detrimental to their recovery. SCP-1048-C resembles a teddy bear similar to 1048, but composed entirely of rusted metal scraps. It was first sighted by Dr. Carver in his office while writing up a report on the 1048B incident. It fled the room when it noticed Dr. Carver observing it. In the attempted pursuit of 1048C, Dr. Carver witnessed the death and maiming of a Foundation personnel, as 1048C exhibited extreme violence during its escape. It has not been encountered since this initial sighting, and is unknown whether it still resides somewhere within Site 24. The origins of any materials possibly used to construct 1048C by 1048 are also unknown at this time. The whereabouts of SCP-1048 are currently unknown, though it is still believed to be somewhere in Site 24. 1048 is to be secured for containment, but any creation of SCP-1048s should be destroyed on site, unless further evidence warrants less extreme actions. No teddy bears are to be allowed in Site 24 to prevent any confusion or mistaken identity. Any object that resembles a teddy bear is to be reported to the security team immediately. Extreme caution is to be taken if SCP-1048-A or SCP-1048-C are encountered again. The Record of Diary of a Young Girl is a story about the discovery of SCP-1048 before the Foundation. It was written by a little youngster named Lizzie Byrne, who discovered 1048 in the top room of her new home, and she named it Benny. Ever since then, Benny and Lizzie became best friends. Benny would give her hugs, and she would hide him in the toy cabinet or under her dress. When 1048's atypical properties were found by Lizzie's mother, she started to yell about it being unnatural and took it away from Lizzie. After that incident, Lizzie wrote in her diary, "Today, Mommy had to go to the doctor. I don't know why, but Daddy and the doctor said Mommy will be gone for a long time now. They won't let me see Mommy." Heavily implied that she was killed by 1048. SCP-1048 later built a living copy out of Lizzie's baby brother Tommy, and another made by her dad. She named it Davy. The fate of Lizzie and how SCP-1048 was discovered by the Foundation remains unknown. Before we end this video, we are proud to present these incredibly sweet pieces of fan art. A big thank you to all of you. You can now send us your fan art, and we will be more than happy to show off your best art piece in our next video. Check out our description below on how to submit. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Which SCP do you want to see in the next video and why it is interesting? Let us know in the comment below. We will draw your story and share it with the world. Don't forget to click like, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell. Please share it to your friends if you like this video. Thank you so much for watching, and we will see you in the next video. Bye-bye!